according to this rating. The indoor display items include bypass, part 1, ally observed resistance against French colonialists from September 1945 to September 1953, part 2, Điện Biên Phủ campaign, part 3, were people assistance to Điện Biên Phủ campaign, part 4, impact of Điện Biên Phủ campaign, and part 5, on the room. Ladies and gentlemen, in order to have a peaceful, integrated, and developed Điện Biên as today, many generations didn't regret their blood and bones fighting with enemies to get sovereignty for the North Wetland of the county. With 36 years of General Võ Nguyên Giáp, Commander-in-Chief of Vietnamese People and Army. Let's come back to Việt Bắc 67 years ago, where originated Điện Biên Phủ campaign. Ladies and gentlemen, in front of us is the model of Politburo working tent at Tiền Keo, Định Hóa, Thái Nguyên, in the small symbol tent at Việt Bắc base, where was called the resistance capitals, took place many decisive meetings for the resistance against French colonialists, especially on the 6th December 1953, President Ho Chi Minh chaired Politburo meeting to listen to General Military Committee to report determination and plan to attack Điện Biên Phủ. In the tent is a set of clusters which shows this important meeting includes President Ho Chi Minh, General Secretary Trường Chinh, General Võ Nguyên Giáp, and Deputy Prime Minister Phạm Văn Đồng. At this meeting, Điện Biên Phủ was decided to be decisive at 36th place. At the same time, established Party Center Committee and better command by General Võ Nguyên Giáp to be Secretary and Commander of the battle. In early January 1954, before coming to the front, General Võ Nguyên Giáp came to ask for instructions from Uncle Ho. At this meeting, President Ho Chi Minh graciously recommended General, Commander-in-Chief goes to the front. You have a full right to decide everything. This battle is important. Must fight to win, not sure, not fight. In order to have that victory, Vietnamese people and army had to spend 9 long-term resistance years. Please come into the historical milestones in that 9 long-term resistance years. Under the leadership of the party and President Ho Chi Minh, Vietnamese people and army unanimously stood up to wage General Revolution August 1945 and got power just 15 days from the 14th to 28th August 1945. Especially on the 2nd September 1945, at historical Baden Square, President Ho Chi Minh solemnly read the Declaration of Independence, fathering Democratic Republic of Vietnam. From that, Vietnam has named on world map as an independent country. French colonialists couldn't bear with the failure on the 23 September 1945. They came back to invade Vietnam for the second time and provoke insurrection. Before that situation, President Ho Chi Minh raised a resistance call for the whole country. We would rather sacrifice everything than lose our country and to be slavers. Responding that resistance call, Tây Nguyên guerrillas built fighting villages to stop enemies' attack. Right after getting powers, on the 6th January 1946, a general election took place in the whole country, presented temporary government of Democratic Republic of Vietnam. In order to mark majority of Vietnamese people and army, Brigade 308, the first major brigade of Vietnamese people and army, was established at Đồn Đu Thao, Phú Lương District and Thái Nguyên Province. The first high command, a brigade 3OS, includes Commander Vương Thừa Vũ, Police Commissar Chính Hào, and Deputy Brigade Cao Văn Khánh. Ladies and gentlemen, self-reliance is one of the contents of Vietnamese Army resistance lines. Implementing that resistance lines, Vietnamese arms factories had a lot of investments to supply for from. Here are rudimentary weapons that Vietnamese people use to against French colonialists, includes crossbow, matchlock, and broadwood. In Glasgow, on the displays, rocket bomb, bazooka, produced at Giang Thiên Arms Factory in April 1947. These are the first invention of Professor Trần Đại Nghĩa. Ladies and gentlemen, Vietnamese people not only fought enemy by rudimentary or modern weapons, but also the items in their house. Introducing to you the Pai Wai Cha of Thai people in Mộc Châu Sơn La, used to discharge poisonous pups into wine for enemy to drink. And the result was that we arrested 12 French soldiers without needs and bullets. In order to save failure after 7 years carrying aggressive war in Vietnam, on the 7th May 1953, with the agreement of US, French government sent General Henry Navarre to replace General Salan to be commander-in-chief of French expeditionary troops in Indochina. After coming to Vietnam for more than 1 month, researching, surveying the battlefield in July 1953, Navarre had already designed the plan named himself. And this is Navarre's plan. Ladies and gentlemen, his story has an interesting coincidence that on the 7th May 1953, Navarre went to Vietnam. But only 1 year later, on the 7th May 1954, Navarre and entire French expeditionary troops had to withdraw from Indochina and end of the military career in failure at Điện Biên Phủ campaign. This is the picture of Lai Châu Town after Liberation Day. Now is Vân Anh Town, 100 kilometers from Điện Biên Phủ city. Here, on the 10th December 1953, Vietnamese soldiers attacked liberated Lai Châu, surrounded Điện Biên Phủ, to be strongly beaten in Lai Châu. Enemy ran back to Điện Biên Phủ. Vietnamese soldiers were ordered to stop enemies from retreating to Điện Biên Phủ. In Mường Bồn, the battle took place very fiercely. Comrade Bé Văn Đàn's units almost sacrificed only 17 people and 2 guns left. A live machine gun couldn't fight because the gunner sacrificed. Comrade Chu Văn Phú's gun, although couldn't fight because there was no place to put the gun. The situation was very urgent. Comrade Bé Văn Đàn ran back and put the gun on his shoulder and shouted, "Shoot, shoot to advance for comrades." Chu Văn Phú was hesitant. Bé Văn Đàn said, "Enemy is in front of us. If you love me, shoot them to death." Comrade Chu Văn Phú gritted his teeth, shot at enemies and killed 10 of them. At this battle, Comrade Bé Văn Đàn suffers from 2 more wounds and he bravely sacrificed. And the result was that at this battle, Vietnamese soldiers exterminated 24 enemy company. Introducing to you the photo at the end of December 1953 and early January 1954, coordinated with Laos people and army to fight enemy in center, lower and upper Laos, losing enemy's vitality, liberating many Laos areas, continue to put Navaf into passive defense situation. Ladies and gentlemen, the more Vietnamese troops fought, the more we got stronger. The more French troops fought, the more they got failure. So how did French colonialists have a new conspiracies and actions? Please continue to visit